My name is Jacob Wellington. I graduated 6 months ago from Horology at BCU, and I am now a watchmaker in London, and I service mechanical watches. So first up, what is Horology? It's a very good question. Horology is the study of timekeeping in all of its forms, from turret clocks right down to tiny ladies' pocket watches and ladies' wristwatches. And it's the study of how they keep time. On to the next one. Why is horology important? Horology is important, well, to me, because it conserves the past, and we've always liked to keep time, especially ships needed to know the time for where they were when they were sailing and they couldn't see any land. We need time nowadays because everyone's got to work, everyone's got alarms. So time's been pretty standard for the last 500 years. Is horology a good career? I would say so. It's a very rewarding career, especially when these watches and clocks have so much history. If they're 300 years old, someone's owned them for 300 years, and it's really interesting to know these stories. For example, pocket watches that were given to the military, and they have a broad arrow and serial numbers. You can find out who it was given to, when it was given, and to me, that's fascinating. What does a horologist do? A horologist does many, many things. A horologist goes from working in your local market for changing batteries on a watch to restoring Big Ben. All of those are horologists, so it's a very broad term, but in the industry generally, horologists are used to fix, conserve and repair mechanical timekeeping devices. What skills do you need to study horology? Patience is a good one. Dexterity as well. When you're dealing with a watch that measures about an inch across and it's got over 100 parts, the parts are quite small, often delicate. To be able to examine the parts, replace them if necessary, or fix them, you need to be very careful. Is horology just about watches? No, and it's something that I hope I've portrayed in this. Horology isn't just watches, it's everything. It's clocks, it's alarm clocks, it's public clocks in church towers, it's sundials, it's anything that can tell the time is horology. How do I get started with horology? Well, I can tell you how I got started. I got started with horology when I had a watch I got for my 15th birthday and the battery died. Out of curiosity, I wanted to fix it myself because I like knowing how things worked, and I've always enjoyed Lego, things like that, building things, working with my hands and problem solving. And when this battery died, I thought, I tell you what, it can't be that hard. We'll have a go. And I bought a cheap set of tools off eBay, took the case back off, and for a watch that measured 50 odd millimeters across, what powered the watch was a tiny, tiny movement in the middle. And then the first question I had was, why is the case so big if the movement is so small? And then one thing led to another. I bought some more watches, I took them apart, I went to some shops, and very quickly you fall into a rabbit hole, which is horology, and next thing you know, you're at Birmingham studying it for 3 years and you've got a job in the career.